Thank you, Mr. Speaker, members of the House, to the bill. This is no ordinary bill we're debating here. When I first came to Springfield, one of the most common pieces of advice I got was don't take anything personally. And usually that's incredibly sound advice. I can't do that with this bill, as this bill could not be more personal. This bill goes directly to how I am defined, how my family is defined by this state. Whether Kelly and I can care for each other when we're sick, whether our family can be considered real, whether we are as valued as members of this community as any other. That's what we're debating here today. You've met my boys. Josh, Daniel, and Ethan are watching today. They face those questions about our family. Not just on the playground where you might expect it, but here, in this very building, this cathedral of justice. We spend a lot of time here together during session. Inevitably, we end up talking about our families. And as we've shared our stories and talked about parent-teacher conferences and soccer schedules and recitals and the things and the people that we miss when we're not here, when we're not there, these have been very simply shared experiences of our families. And I never got the sense from any of you in those conversations that you thought of our family as somehow less than. Our experiences are the same, except for how we are protected and valued by the state. And we are treated as less than by this state that all of us in this room love enough to serve. Last year I got the call that we all dread. My partner Kelly was being rushed to the hospital in excruciating pain, and I left here at the crack of dawn in a hurry to get home to her. On the way home, in addition to the thoughts that we all would have under the circumstances, will I get there in time, what's wrong, what her condition might be, I also worried that I wouldn't be allowed in to see her when I got there, and wondered if I should take the extra time to go all the way home and find that durable power of attorney for healthcare. I was weighing the risks of going straight to her side or spending another hour in transit to get a piece of paper to prove that we were real. The worries about making it to her on time are worries we would all share, but there are only a handful of us in this room that would have that other worry and that other question to weigh about that extra hour of transit. Until our relationships are on an equal footing, there will always be questions to answer under those circumstances. This vote today isn't about the next election or even the one after that. This is about a question you'll face at some point in the future. What did you do when faced with this historic moment? Whether that future is embodied in my boys or your kids, your nieces and nephews, your grandchildren, or that boy at your son's high school who's being bullied because he's just too different for your small town. It is their opinion of your actions today that should determine what you do. Which really brings me to the piece of advice that I got that always applies. You will never regret doing the right thing. Today, the right thing is to tell my family, these families here today and watching us, and those kids wondering if it really does get better, that you are valued, you are equal. Cast your vote for equality, for the right thing. Please, vote yes and join us on the right side of history.